if you're using Calendly in your team and you've got shared events, there are really two kinds of shared events that you need to know about. I'm going to share that with you based on the Calendly documentation. Now, full disclosure, I don't have access to the right Calendly account here, so I'm not going to do a demo, but I'm going to walk you through some of the documentation just to explain it and explain how it might be used in your situation. If you have a team and you are using Calendly so people can book events, there's a couple of things that you need to know. The first is, when you use Calendly as a team, each team member has their own personal Calendly link, but they've all got access to the premium or pro features within their account. So that means that as you add new team members, you're going to be charged for each of those team members. So that centralized billing on the main account. Now, there are two very different kinds of events that are worth knowing about. There's the round robin event, which is effectively sharing the load of appointments on rotating around the team. The other one is the collective event, and that's where you want all of the team together or a group of people together all at the same time. So a couple of examples. The collective event might be, for example, a job interview. Imagine a few of you are going to be interviewing a candidate for a job interview. So you could set up that up as a collective shared event. And so that means that the invitees can pick a time, but you've all got to be available at the same time. Okay? And so here's how to do it. You go to your homepage, new event type, and then create a collective event. And of course, you set the event name, description, how long it's going to go for, and availability, and so on. The other kind is the round robin, which is sharing the load. That's allowing appointments to be allocated in rotation so that you don't get one person lumped with all of the appointments and nobody else does any of the work. But you can say that, well, okay, this many events per day. So somebody may have four, for example, sales presentations per day. The minimum scheduling notice, so they've got to get advance notice so that they don't just get a surprise message to say you've got a call in 10 minutes they've had no preparation for. You can optimize for availability. And that really allows the people who are booking the event to book with any hosters available at their preferred time, okay? Or the other way is really to share the load or optimize for equal distribution. This is really to stop an overload of one team member when the others are not getting and are not carrying the load. So one team member can't be scheduled for more than three meetings ahead of the others. So that way it's to share the load. So those are two different ways of doing the round robin events, round robin or the collective event, two very different kinds of events. Of course, when you dig deeper into these, you can see that you can add team members, you can remove team members, you can remove them from these events, or you can remove them altogether from your account. And the other thing that's pretty interesting is that you can create event type templates for users. And what that allows you to do is to set up, hey, this is a standard event. For example, we're doing a research interview, and we're going to be doing some customer experience, some CX interviews or customer success interviews. And so these are the questions that we're going to be asking. You can include all of that in the agenda, and then that way people can already have that template set up every time. They don't have to copy and paste it from somewhere else or write it fresh each time. So check out the description in the video beneath this video to see more details on how you can create and manage a team and how you can create those two kinds of events. And if you check out my channel, you'll find some other videos about Calendly, including some demos.